Einstein essentially was stating that by its nature the ether could not be detected. However, Einstein also mapped the anti-consistency by saying that if the ether could be detected, that his theory of relativity was an error. Einstein further stated that if the light could travel like a particle, it would not need a medium, ether, to travel through, even though most of the great scientists of the day, such as Maxwell, Faraday, Kelvin, Fitzgerald, and Lorentz, all accepted the obvious conclusion that there had to be a medium of transfer in space, an example the ether, all of this was a glossed over. Since in the Michelson-Morley experiment, light traveled at the same speed in the direction the Earth was moving, and at right angles to that direction, Einstein concluded that the speed of light had to be constant, according to special relativity. He further suggested in 1905 that the ether of the 19th century physics was not necessary, although what he really meant to say was it could not be detected. At the time, this was a radical view. It was soon widely accepted, even though it implied that there was nothing between the stars. This concept quickly became dogma as it helped solve a number of dilemmas. For instance, they no longer had to search for the ether because according to this view, it didn't exist. The perspective of popular science writers. Belief in the non-existence of the ether remained alive, but in actuality, by 1916, Einstein had replaced the old ether in his theory of general relativity by curved spacetime itself. Only this new ether is no longer a medium in three-dimensional Euclidean space, but in four-dimensional non-Euclidean curved space-time. It was this idea that was completely unacceptable to Tesla, and he criticized Einstein in the 1930s because of it. Concerning the curvature of space, Einstein versus the idea of a force field, Tesla, the two concepts might actually be different, viable ways of describing the same thing. Both Tesla and Einstein are trying to describe the fundamental structure of space and its relationship to the constancy of light speed and gravity. Basically it's this, Nikola Tesla back then was a proponent of the ether theory, and he said that Einstein's theories of special relativity were wrong and could not practically be real. And most scientists back then also accepted the fact that there was an ether. Now we will check out a short video on the so-called omnion particle that makes actually this ether all around us. The omnion is the smallest particle that makes up this ether. It is from BibliothecaPleiades.net. Occult Ether Physics, Hidden Space Propulsion Systems and the Conspiracy to Conceal It, by William Lyon. The truth can flow from lies, but lies can flow from the truth, Arthur Schopenhauer. Characteristics of the basic ether particles. My basic ether particle is called the omni, which has a positive nucleus, a protet called an omnion, and a negative sub-10 electron, an electret called an omnitron. As you may have noticed, this gives a scaled-down version of the basic hydrogen atom, with its proton and electron. For most atoms, the omni is normally neutral and in equilibrium, but it is much smaller in size, being ultra-fine. Due to its tiny size and neutrality, it can pass easily through solid bodies. Except the solid bodies that are actually passing by and through it. Yet it behaves like a solid in respect to high-frequency electromagnetic radiation of specific range, from the infrared through the visible light frequencies, which disturb its equilibrium. Yet, though, we can feel it. It appears to be transparent and invisible to the naked eye. Like hydrogen gas, there's some elasticity due to the compressibility of the magnetic field, so it is an elastic solid, as Faraday said. Due to the tiny omni-size, so-called empty space is actually packed almost solid with this very fine matter, or omniparticles, which oscillates at such high frequencies, well beyond that of the X-rays, yet the tiny size and normal neutrality allows it to penetrate solid mass, which is mostly space, which is also saturated with omni, which must be moved through by a mass to make room for more omni. Since interstellar space is equivalent to a vacuum containing little gaseous matter, such as a Leonard tube in which charges easily move, the omni in interstellar space is highly conductive, with charges moving freely from body to body along magnetic lines of force. Omnipack space is also omnidirectly interpenetrated by ultrafine radiation, which is normally in equilibrium, called zero-point radiation. The basic differences now between official theory that is taught at schools and the universities and hasn't really led us any further. We did not develop any technologies that actually neutralize practically the gravity around us and creating anti-gravitics, as the UFOs are working on it. The improved German Sonnenbus Rills and Andromeda spacecraft use anti-gravitics, but they base themselves on a different science. And I believe in ether physics. what Nikola Tesla was a proponent of about. You have to understand that ether physics states that it's an energy all around us. This is really tiny packed energy, really high density energy that is all packed around us, and it inhibits the same space that is apparently empty. And electromagnetism, electricity, and even electromagnetic radiation uses this medium to propagate its waves. It's practically like a boat in water. Just imagine it. If you want to understand gravity or the force of gravity, if you're driving in water for a boat and you are at a high speed, as an example, and you turn off the motor, you still see that the water is practically pushing you further. The water is actually wants to go through you and pushes you further. This is the omniparticles practically. If you're in an aircraft or in a boat and you change the direction, you feel this force, the centrifugal or centripetal force, pushing you to keep going the normal way that you were going. And this pushing are actually the omniparticles or the ether particles pushing you in that direction. So you actually feel the ether and the effects of ether. And ether is practically also attracted by mass bodies in such a respect that it's the ether radiates downward onto the bodies, onto mass, onto planets as an example, and in this manner it creates gravity. If you take a space station, a rotating space station as an example, if you're rotating space, you create practically a movement in the ether because its ether interacts practically with matter. Yeah, you create a movement in the ether and you create a force that makes the ether flow fluid away from you, generating gravity. It is the same force that keeps us down here. It's practically, if you rotate a space station in orbit, it's the same force. It's the ether going through your body and interacting with your body or the mass. Ether is neutral, but has also electromagnetic properties. And in those days, during Nikola Tesla in the late 1900s actually, this was a theory that was widely circulated in the academia, until Einstein, and with the Zionists globally propagating this theory, the special relativity, that there is no ether, that there is no medium to propagate the magnetic waves or electromagnetic radiation, that there is no medium to procreate these waves, that it's all about space-time curvature, that the mass has a curvature in space, and hence the curvature presses against the mass, and hence gravity is created. I first read about this in SS Brotherhood of the Bell from Joseph P. Farrell, Alternative Ether Physics. I've read about it some time ago, but I've never really actually studied it and thought about it. The ether is practically it's an energy all around us. And if you can tap into this ether, you can create a well, actually. Yeah, a well of energy. You can tap into this and suck practically ether particles out. And in this respect, you can understand these zero-point energy devices that are practically suppressed by our official governments and the shadow government. Even the UFOs, or are the Hanubus on the Rills and Andromeda spacecraft worked, and even the Venusian ships, or they have probably some other technology, but they influence the ether. By influencing the ether, you can actually nullify gravity. As an example, it's stated in these alternative textbooks online that this bell-type ships or spacecraft create a magnetic field around them. They have two tubes, or two circular tubes, that go in different directions, filled with mercury, and it creates practically a vertical magnetic field that separates practically this ship, or the entire ship, that makes practically the ether go around it. It creates a piece of space that is independent of this space, and the ether goes around it, hence the gravity is nullified. So you get a ship that is weightless, actually, or the gravity, or the omnions, the particles, the ether particles that go through it.
They amplify, sample, trample, delete and cancel, they vacate the vessel, guide this, strenuous as an arm wrestle, boom, swift as light, 1,000 years one night, in flight but in sight, everything I thought of, I saw it happen, then I rose from the soil, the sun blackened, then came rap czars, left tracks of stars, I apparent brightness of exploding stars gave you goods to taste. No ingredients to trace, you remain stuck trying to figure the shape of space. No edge of boundary, release two rounds of three. Intimidate, my rage is free, phony clown MC. Your physical shatter from the blast, pyroclastic flow, set forth the tower of ash. Through ignorance and misplaced trust, your world's crushed. Too late to activate hyperspace or thrust. Even wearing camouflage, the analog at war. You seen as high beams of fog that came in, accompanied by deadly rain and wind. Mentally endowed with lightning, hit the crowd. But warm side, let you cross the barrier. But the storm side, destroy your area. The amplify, sample, or trample, delete and cancel. Then vacate your vessel to guide this. Strenuous as an arm wrestle, move swift as light. 1,000 years, one night, in flight but in sight. Everything I thought of, I saw happen. Then I rose from the soil, the sun blackened. Then came rap czars, left tracks of stars. Apparent brightness of exploding stars gave you goods to taste. No ingredients to trace, you remain stuck trying to figure the shape of space. No edge of boundary released, two rounds or three. Intimidate, razor scrape, phony clown MC. Physical, shatter from the blast. Pyroclastic flow, set forth a towel of ash. Through ignorance, misplaced trust, your world's crushed. Too late to activate, hyperspace or thrust. Even when camouflage or analog at war. The scene is high beams of fog that came in, accompanied by deadly rain and wind. Mentally endowed when lightning struck the crowd. But warm side, as you cross the barrier. But my storm tide, will destroy your area. They amplify, sample, or trample, delete and cancel. Then vacate to vessel. The amplify, sample. The amplify, sample. The amplify, sample, trample. The amplify, sample, or trample, delete and cancel. Then vacate to vessel. The amplify. The amplify, sample. The amplify, sample. The amplify. The amplify, sample, or trample, delete and cancel. Sample. The amplify. The amplify, sample, or trample, delete and cancel. The amplify. The amplify.
Ether is neutral, but has also electromagnetic properties. And in those days, during Nikola Tesla in the late 1900s actually, this was a theory that was widely circulated in the academia, until Einstein, and with the Zionists globally, propagating this theory, the special relativity, that there is no ether, that there is no medium to propagate the magnetic waves or electromagnetic radiation, that there is no medium to procreate these waves, that it's all about space-time curvature, that the mass has a curvature in space, and hence the curvature presses against the mass, and hence gravity is created. I first read about this in SS Brotherhood of the Bell from Joseph P. Farrell, Alternative Ether Physics. I've read about it some time ago, but I've never really actually studied it and thought about it. The ether is practically unpermeated, it's an energy all around us. And if you can tap into this ether, you can create a well, actually, yeah, a well of energy.